working with Rick Rubin recently, haven't you? What was that like?
No.
No, you weren't?
Yeah.
What was it like?
It's a lot of fun. We do what we want with Rick.
Because you're the first kind of thrash band that he's actually worked with, aren't you?
Yeah.
So do you think you're responsible for him moving away from things like the Beastie Boys? And...
I guess to some extent, because he's now working with a lot of metal. He's going to be working with metal bands now from now on, I guess. Different metal bands. We're the only really thrash band he's ever really worked with.
And how'd that come about?
Pure luck, I guess.
What was the motivation behind the band? To be the hardest, the most extreme?
Originally.
Yeah. To be the most extreme. And that's what we've done. I think we're an extreme form of metal. And I think we've accomplished that.
Who would you say your influences have been?
You don't want to hear my influences.
I want to hear your influences.
Cree. Hendrix. The Animals. Jefferson Airplane. Those are mine.
How does your music fit in with that?
What's that?
How does your music fit in with them?
As far away as possible, right?
It doesn't fit into that. Those are my influences. That's what I grew up with.
Yeah.
You know, my sisters used to listen to that all the time. The only time I recently started listening to music is when I joined the band with these guys. And I didn't even know metal existed.
That's for sure.
It's true. It's an honest statement. I didn't know the shit existed until he said, hey, you know, why do you say we join the band? These are the songs we're learning. And I said, well, who's this? It was a band called Iron Maiden. He's like, well, who's that?
Disco is disco. Dead. Yay!
Woo. Play our fucking hearts out.
Ooh, what do I do? That was fun.
Epic songs.
We fell off the edge of L.A. poserism.
Yeah.
What's an L.A. poser?
Wait!
I'll show you.
Yeah, wait.
Yeah.
There. Puckery lips, stick up here.
Wait, need another hand.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Grab me in the crotch. Oh, yeah.
Gnostic front, DRI, verbal abuse, black flag, people like that. Just the stuff that pounds in your head. That's exactly what we do.
That's amazing.
Exploited. Dude, we got a beer break here.
Oh, beer break.
This beer sucks. But it's free, you know, so it's great.
With the amount of...
There's one thing. The other bands, they change their style of music. We're not going to change our style of music for a major label. That'll lose a lot of people. No, we're going through the dump.
Is that a spiritual feeling?
Very religious experience.
It's a religious experience.
Go to Baghdad.
Yeah, go to Baghdad.
He comes in here, eats all our food.
No, I mean, our music is inspired by, what was punk?
Classical.
Ooh! Did you get that? Bravo!
Come on, bravo!
Good stuff.
We like Bach.
Yeah, your music seems to be involved Bach. In a way that classical arrangements were also.
Yeah, we like a lot of Bach. And
Bach.
Bach.
Mozart.
Especially Bach.
Beethoven. But you laugh, huh?
Tchaikovsky.
We're serious.
Because I want to grow my hair and work in a hospital.
And we got a chest therapist or whatever you did at the time.
Breast analogist.
Right.
I took it from there and just let it all go into place.
And what inspires Slayer to do what you do?
Speed. Aggression.
Driving through New York and Rich. We'll be right back.
Ragazzi, chi lo vuole con loro? Che ti dà un idea, ci si! Questa è la pace, ciò la mia! Anche se la lotta per il grain! Si, il show che ne ha bisogno! Ci faccio un colore, se ci parla di! Tu non è un run, è un sleep for me, too!
Back to bitch, motherfucker! you for coming. I want to thank you for being a part of this little festival. You guys make this happen, man. Without you, there wouldn't be anybody here. But thank you very much for making this all possible for everybody that's playing today. And yesterday and the day before that. This is of a stain of mine.
Do you go to church or anything like that?
I don't go to church. I used to go to church. I'm a Catholic. I was born a Catholic. I just have belief in myself.
Before you feel alive, you must die.
South of Heaven is basically about hell on earth and how I envision the world. That's the course the world is taking to. By writing a song like that, I'm not saying there's no hope. I'm just sort of telling you what it looks like to me. There's chaos everywhere. Everyone's fighting everyone.
Certainly your first two albums had lots of references to Satan. Does that mean that you take him seriously as a being? Do you think that such a thing really exists?
Do you believe in God?
I don't know.
You don't know?
Well, do you?
Obviously, if there's good, then there's evil. And that's how we look at it. And it's kind of a shock value. I think people are really afraid about this dark image. You know, they really, they kind of, you know, people aren't really sure as to how to take Satan. But I look at it as if there's good, there will always be evil.
Do you think that people could say that if they looked at your lyrics, that maybe you see more evil than good? Because a lot of...
Yeah, we see a lot of morbid things in life. We cover the dark images of life that nobody really wants to talk about.
Jeff just said that Tom used to sing like a tortured pig, but you've become a bit more melodic. You think that you've let people down by...
I still sing like a pig, but I'm just not being tortured. the hardcore kids are the ones that are they're thrash and like the fast stuff, right? Rain and Blood was just like that. They consider that like the thrash album, the ultimate in thrash. You know, you can't, you know, how much further can you take that? You know, then if you took it any further, it'd be stupidly fast, and it wouldn't make any sense. You know, so it's like, you know, me and Jeff feel, and the rest of the band, we feel like we've set the standard for a thrash album. You know, 10 songs, 28 minutes long, you know, an album 28 minutes. You know, that's like the ultimate in thrash. We got a song that it's like a minute and a half that has three verses, two choruses, and two guitar leads. You know, and it's all in a minute and a half. So it's like, that's like, we've set the standard. You know, and, you know, we don't wanna outdo ourselves or really just go overboard, because then you're crossing the line between metal or thrash metal and punk.
Thank you. Jesus, 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 Jes